this phenylephrine with the lidocaine. A very weak dilution of phenylephrine, non-preserved. I like to make a little scratch incision to get a good start to the tunnel. It's a 2.2 millimeter keratome. So we have viscoed in the eye. I'm going to paint the surface of this brunescent lens. Just a little bit of vision blue and then spread it around. So I'm just right on the capsule. So I haven't injected any more right now, but now I'm going to. Just going to make sure that this part is covered too, so I'm injecting right on it because it's deceiving with the vision blue coming out the channel through the viscote. You think that it's stained here, but it's not unless you inject right on it. And with the cohesive retentive viscoat, you can flush out a little bit of the vision blue. Just very gentle flush here with the SS. And now I'm going to aspirate, see if that does any better, but I think, see how that isn't stained back with more vision blue. And come through the side port incision. So I was aspirating there. Now hopefully we'll have a little viscote left to clear that as much as possible and make sure we have flat capsule to do the capsulorhexis. And I like to stabilize the eye for capsulorhexis. See that sudden movement?
doctor and you had to cough a little bit here.
Okay. Perfect timing for a cough. Light as bright as it'll go.
Yes.
Maybe very loose sonules here because that capsule didn't want to tear. Just lifting the anterior capsule off here. Put in a little provisc there just to get a nice concave surface to the viscote. Try not to occlude here. While I'm sculpting, and you notice my nudging the nucleus so that I can sculpt more in the posterior pole. I want to thin the posterior plate as much as possible to facilitate fracture there. Now we'll engage, get under the capsule. Hold with vacuum only while I try to get a fracture in this rim. And try to extend it. Okay, I'm going to turn the nucleus to try to complete that fracture. Why? No. So there we got that complete now. Notice how I hold the second instrument just in front of and under the phaco tip. Becomes more important as we remove the second half here. Thank you. the side of the nucleus like this. And again, this is the most critical time to have that second instrument under the tip. That posterior capsule is wanting to come forward. Chunks here that get trapped in the incisions. Like to encourage those to come to the tip before leaving the chamber. Silicone IA tip, we can vacuum off epithelial cells. Probably need the bent 30 here.
Could you tell us your name, please? Could you tell us your name?
Polish, please. Cortex here, I can't reach with the IA tip, so. Do you have the right angled one? Use this first. Not sure if there's any over here, but we'll just explore. This is on a syringe, and I'm just manually creating a little vacuum here. Tina make two different bent 30 tipped cannulas here. This one's more right angled.
Mm-hmm.
through the paracentesis with this too. And note that I'm doing this after I put the Provisc in the eye. Just leave it there, and the IA will get it after the lens is in.
Try this. Yeah, that's good. You okay there?
Yes.
Okay. I just keep pushing the plunger out to use it as my instrument to tuck the lens into the bag. Try to use a very high vacuum because the cohesive Provisc will come out more completely if you have high vacuum than low vacuum. And I go under the lens, and there's often a little bit trapped there because I was stabilizing the lens. Otherwise, the Provisc coming out and the high flow can. Just a sec.
You're already frozen from the first drop.
Yeah,
it's
frozen now, so
it just felt like it was all around the outside.
Okay.
Down tickling my throat to make me cough.
Okay, we're just about finished here.
My right arm is getting sore too.
50. So now that our incisions are dry, I'll put the vancomycin into the bag under the lens. Water on the surface. And then center the lens. And I'm just filling the chamber now with BSS again. Expecting that some vanco is trapped under there. But I'll add a little vanco now to the anterior chamber. And again, check the incisions. Looks like I'll have to hydrate that a little more. Very firm eye, so a little more vanco. like checking the pressure, just pushing with the tip of the Bexell sponge or the handle of the Bexell sponge. And I don't like to leave the surgery until I can demonstrate both incisions are dry. You're all finished.